Okay.
Would you like me to spell them?
Yes, please.
Okay, so the first name is Shona, S-H-O-N-A. The last name is Gokunar, G-O-C-H-E-N-A-U-R.
I appreciate it very much. Sounds like you've done this before. Tell me the name of your organization, please.
It's Axis of Love, S-F, and it's A-X-I-S. So like Axis, like a...
Got it. Is this one of your friends or something?
Yeah. Maybe I should step back one step. Okay.
You know these people, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Very yes.
Good. Okay. I was going to say you have fans already. Well, tell me what your feeling is about this.
So my feeling is that we don't need further restrictions. We need further support and patients' access. It's going to become very unaffordable for many patients. So patient advocacy groups and industry groups are supporting compassionate care. And when we look at the 600 to 1,000 feet, we're wondering why a city that is a sanctuary for medical cannabis would put forward restrictions that are more restrictive than our entire state voted on. So we're hoping that the supervisors take the direction of the state and ensure that every neighborhood has access for the patients.
Senator Wiener, who previously was on the Board of Supervisors, posted a map, sounds like you've seen it, yes, that showed a couple of green points of where these dispensaries might be able to go based on these restrictions, and there wasn't a lot of them or much space. And so he reached out to his former colleagues and asked them to consider what you're asking for. Are you familiar with his post? Do you appreciate
yes,
he did that?
I appreciate that he did that and I did share it. However, it is Supervisor Jane Kim that is looking at doing some amends to assure that the small businesses and the equity programs are going to be exempt from any type of restrictions that may be. If we go up to the 1,000 feet, she's looking at exempting our small businesses and our equity programs. So I think that we have people on both, the conservative and moderate side of our former board looking at how to preserve the small and equity businesses. In San Francisco, by policy direction, is small business friendly. So I hope that, our city continues the tradition of being a compassion-based sanctuary city for medical cannabis patients and really supports the 600 feet and really supports the mandatory compassionate care programs that many of us are asking for.
I just, play devil's advocate here. Some of the suggestions about distance between schools or daycare centers. Do you understand that perspective, that point of view?
Well, we dealt with this when we worked with then Supervisor Mercurini in 2005. We are the longest standing patient advocacy group, so we've dealt with these concerns before, and our take on it is the reason we're not concerned about the daycare and the preschool is that that's the parents' responsibility. Those are children so young, we don't impact. It's not a high school, it's not a middle school. There's really no impact from our community on daycares and preschool. So I think that that's being used, and the unfortunate side of it is that if they add that, all, even our standing dispensaries are in jeopardy. And it's just, it's meaningless. It comes from more of a perspective of not understanding the true land use impacts and coming from a perspective more zealotry than actual impact. And we want to stay focused on science and what's actually going to impact land use.
Thank you so much. Do you plan on speaking today?
I do.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Thanks for taking the time.